In this lesson, you will learn how to visualize geolocated data. Geolocated data is data tied to geographical places, such as streets or cities. Location data is most commonly encoded using two values, latitude and longitude. If in your dataset you have location names but you don't have latitude and longitude, you will need to use a service that transforms place names into geocoordinates. There are many tools available to work with geolocated data, but most of them are either too complex to use or they are not free. In this lesson, you will learn how to use Kepler.gl, an open source web application. You can use Kepler.gl anytime you have data about specific locations such as streets, neighborhoods, cities, or countries. Kepler.gl is a powerful open source geospatial analysis tool for large-scale datasets. In simple words, you can use Kepler to design geographic visualization, commonly known as maps. Keplergl is a client-based web application. This means that first, your data stays only on your machine. No information or map data is sent to any server. Second, you need to export your project if you want to work on it later. To use Kepler, go to Kepler.gl and press Get Started. Here, you can load your data. You can drop a file into the window or you can click the link Browse your file. Kepler accepts CSV, JSON and GeoJSON file. For this tutorial, we will use a dataset of UFO sightings in the US from 1993 to 2005. Drag the file from your computer into the window. Kepler will load and automatically visualize all the data contained in the file. Let's go over Kepler interface. On the left, you have the main panel. In the main panel, you can control layers, filters, interactions, and the base map. Layers are visual encoding of your data. You can add as many as you want, for example, loading multiple datasets. All your available data are visible at the top of the layer panel. If you go over the dataset and click on the icon Show Data Table, you can have a preview of your dataset. Here you can see how Kepler has interpreted each column as a date, as a number, as a string, or a geographical feature. In the Filters panel, you can filter your data according to different fields contained in the dataset. In the Interaction panel, you can control the interactive elements of your map. For example, you can customize tooltips. Tooltips are small informative boxes visualized when you go over some element in the map. The last panel, Base Map, allows you to customize the look of the base map, choosing which geographical features are displayed and which ones are hidden. Here, you can also change the base map style or add your own importing from other services such as Mapbox. On the right of the screen, you have three more options. You can divide the screen into two parts and map different data to make comparison. You can switch to a 3D view of the map. You can show or hide the legend that Kepler has automatically created for you. Let's go back to the layer panel. Click on the down arrow to open the layer settings. You can choose which visual model you want to use to visualize your data. You can choose among many options. For example, instead of points, we can see a grid of density and define the grid size or use hexagonal binning. You can then customize the visual variables of your map by choosing which columns of your dataset you want to map. For example, we can choose to color each circle based on the length of the sighting encounter. Click on the three points near the color and then click on the field Color Based On. Clicking on the color scheme, you can choose others. Let's choose a sequential color scheme from blue to pink. In the same way, you can set the radius of circle according to the same field and then increase the overall size to make it more visible. When you are done, you can close the layer option. Layers can be hidden by clicking on the small eye icon. Let's hide this layer and create a new one. Okay. To add a new layer, click on the green button that says Add Layer. Let's choose a heatmap visualization. Kepler always needs to know in which column latitude and longitude are stored. Choose the two columns from the drop-down menu. Now you can increase the radius and modify the opacity of the heatmap. We can close the layer and rename it. Let's call it heatmap. Okay. When you are done working on your map, you can click on the Share button at the top left of the interface. On Kepler, you have four export options. You can export a static image of your map. You can export a dataset. This is useful if you have applied a filter or merged together two different datasets. You can export an interactive map as an HTML file. To do this, you will need to enter your Mapbox access token. Mapbox is the service that provides the map base layer. In this section, you can also decide to export a JSON file that you can use later to reopen your project on Kepler. Finally, you can choose to share your map as a public URL. To do this, you will need to link Kepler to your Dropbox account. In conclusion, in this lesson, you have seen how to use Kepler.gl to visualize location data. Always remember that in order to design maps with Kepler, you need a dataset with geo-coordinates.